Hi all, so I want to make this video here on a niche research for a low content book, right? So I've decided that I want to look at food journals, for example. So typing in just food journal, we find that there is food journals for weight loss, for tracking meals and exercise, intolerance for women, for diabetics, right? And then we get further down the order, we have for eating disorders for kids, for food allergies, for ulcerative colitis, for blood sugar. You want to do activity tracking. So the world surrounding food is a very deep ocean, and that's what I always keep wanting to talk about when it comes to the low content game. It's really about that deep ocean and how many different aspects there are. So we can find niches inside of these topics to really target, right? So we have, you know, a food journal with a planner, you know, prep guides, people that are calorie counts, people with macros. I mean, if you go down into it, we look at the different types of food categories out there, or diet categories. You have the zone diet, the HCG diet, the Atkins diet, ultra low fat, Dunkin', low carbs, vegan, paleo, raw food, South Beach, Weight Watchers, vegetarian, ketogenic, the Atkins, which is pretty close to keto, right? The list goes on and on and on. So if we, you know, look into that, we can find you know, for different conditions too, like IBS, you know, people with Crohn's disease, people with this, people with that, right? So everybody has their own thing when it comes to food, and, you know, being able to track your food is what is key to weight loss, and, you know, being able to do your recipes, doing meal prep, you know, and all these sort of things, food sensitivity, right? There's a great journal for it, you know, load FODMAP. Food diary, you know, I mean, there are just so many different options when it comes to food. So that's why I wanted to make this video and just kind of go after a niche. And let me clear up from my last session here in this space, right? And there's so many different keywords that can go with it. So that's why I wanted to take a minute, because and kind of go through my process when I've kind of thought of something and have that aha moment. It's like, huh, I really think that's something I should go after. So I open up myself a notepad here for me to write down my keywords and on different lines and kind of track my results when it comes to it. So let's get into it. So as we get into it here, you know, I kind of got my base idea and then I start with my search. So we'll just start with our root keyword, which is food journal. And obviously, because I was prepping for this one, I was like, huh, this is a really deep ocean to look at, you know, and we had found it together on one of our previous sessions, because I found this food journal bariatric, right? I said, wow, there's some opportunity, right? So we're going to go after that opportunity. And now for bariatric, we're going to actually just go and look up, well, what is bariatric, right? So bariatric means and treats those who have obesity to promote weight loss. Bariatric surgery, right? So what I do with that is I'm going to find like synonym.com or find synonyms, right? So we can go to synonyms, not symptom checker, synonyms. There we go. I can spell it out to myself sometimes or sound it out, right? So I like to go to like synonyms, and I like to put in bariatric, and I like to say, well, what other terms are there that surrounds the word bariatric? There's no synonyms for bariatric, right? Okay, interesting. So we can then just look into it and just see, you know, weight loss surgery has to do with your digestive system, right? All right, so now we got some other ideas of keywords. So we could use like, let's just use like weight loss journey. See what comes up, and maybe we go into, we could go into symptoms, right? So of digestive issues. So let's say like IBS food log and food sensitivity, right? And wow, we get a whole bunch of stuff. So IBS food log, that's actually a pretty one to good to go one to go after there, right? So we have our IBS food log. So if I find my thing here, so I like that. I like that a lot. There's only 602 competitors. There's about 2,100 searches a month. Competition is about 60. There's definitely some room to make some money in that space right there, right? So we got our food sensitivity. Let's see what we got. Cookbook, nothing. Journal, nothing. When I say nothing, I'm looking at the searches per month. So people aren't really using the word food sensitivity so much as they are other stuff, as lab tests. I mean, so we might need to find out what terms are they also searching for that. So let's do maybe IBS general, right? And then let's do like IBS food. But in IBS, right away, we found cookbooks. Ah, here we go, right? So IBS cookbooks. So we're not really going to make a, you know, maybe we'll do IBS recipe. Something like that, right? Right, the recipe book. See, that's a good one. People are looking for recipe books for that. So we can make like a little log book for that. And when we get down into it, we have our food diaries. See, this is a good one. Let's see what we found here is we found IBS food diaries, right? We found a decent little niche here where there's very little competition. Not really much going on. There's definitely some room to attack, right? And this is what we're looking for. That one's good too there. IBS food system symptom journal. I mean, we got some great keywords there. IBS, constipation, elimination diet, cookbook, food diary, food journal. I think some of those, see, we got IBS journal, right? Very low competition, not much going on, but we have some decent searches. So this is awesome, right? We're finding a lot of good things there. Food sensitivity. Not so much going on there, right? We don't have as much as we would have liked going on there. So let's go back to maybe weight loss and how we found that very bariatric. This area might be saturated. It might not be. Look at this, 60 competition, only 1,000 things in there. Weight loss journey journal. I mean, to me, that's like, why isn't there more going on there? People are really into that. So that's just the power of these long tail keywords when it comes to finding something that works. And that's what this is all about. It's all about thinking about those things, find those little cherries that are like, huh, let me go after that. Let me go down that hole and let me see what's in that rabbit hole. And that's where we started finding things. So we did weight loss journey, right? So, weight loss journal, I bet you as a whole is probably pretty full. Yeah, you see there's a lot going on there, but we add those weird words like journey or whatever else to it. So obesity log, maybe. I mean, I don't know if that's going to come back with anything. Not so much. So we're going to kind of back off here a little bit, kind of got overloaded with my IBS thing there. And we're gonna keep looking and we're just gonna go down the food journal route. So we're gonna say eating activity. I don't know. Because they could call it like activity logbook, right? So look at that. Eating activity. Not very competitive. Mindful eating. Okay. So that's got to be a big thing in the weight loss space, right? So let's look at mindful eating, maybe mindful food, just for fun, see what comes up. So mindful eating book, workbook, right? So we like workbooks, low content, got some searches, not many competitors, okay? Mindful eating journal. Look at that. Boom. This one's nice. We gotta highlight this. 35 competition, 1,000 searches a month, 278 competitors, mindful eating journal. And what I like to do when I find really good ones like that, put some stars next to it. So let's check out our competition and let's see what they got. Let's just open it up, check it out. They made $15. They've been up there a little while. They're making some money. This guy eat pretty live well. He's killing it. This is good. Right. Anyway, let's check these out. So this one's not getting much sales, but this one is. So I want to open up both of those. I want to see what's going on. I want to know what I would have to create to play in this space. So this mindful eating journal. This is not a low content, and it is $25. Wow. It is spiral bound. Well, they did a wow. That's pretty in depth. A little bit more than low content. I think there's some availability here for us low content publishers. For sure. So this is a great little that's a great little find. I am very happy with that. So let's keep looking at that mindful eating, right? So we found mindful eating workbooks and books and Mindful Eating Journal, that's the one that we said was like gold diary. Not much going on there. But this is what this is all about. It's about using the tools that we have and those niche ideas. So mindful eating, that was pretty good. That was pretty good. What else can we find here in our weight loss journeys, right? So maybe I want to go on the mindful trip, right? Mindful weight loss. See what comes up. Bum, 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 bum. Not so much. So IBS was doing good. Let's see here. Maybe like a Crohn's disease. Let's see here. Crohn's diary. Crohn's. I don't know if I spelled that right. We're going to go and find out here. Crohn diary. Crohn's diary. Nothing really going on there. Let's just look at Crohn's in general, see what comes up. Crohn. Crohn's disease cookbook. Okay. Might be able to do a recipe book. Crohn's journal. Not much going on there. Let's look up maybe a different way of looking at things like diary for weight. I like using the foreword now because Google is actually about to do an update to their analytics that helps. The foreword is actually in certain conjunctive words like that are actually supposed to be pretty good at helping out. Keeping a food diary for weight loss. I wonder why it says there are not many competitors there. That's interesting. Very interesting. Anyway, I don't want to make this too long. I'm going to spend a couple more minutes, probably about 20 on this, looking for some more words because I want to get my list here up to more than, like 20 or 30. Because if I decide to make several covers, different words to try out, different long tails to put together after this, right? So we're going to do, IBS food log for men, IBS food log for women, and put those other long tails into it to see what happens. And let's say the weight loss, or let's say IBS food, IBS, or yeah, men's IBS. I'm gonna play around with some of these other kind of short shorter terms that get put on the long term just to see what comes up. But we can also use our search expander here, you know, and just say IBS food and just see what that one, you know, maybe comes out and tells us, you know, men's IBS, no, men, IBS food. And we'll go with maybe that food journal we started with. So food journal. And we might want to look at, we had food journal for IBS, you know, maybe even for blood pressure or something like that. You know, we might want blood pressure and we might want to try and track that down. Blood pressure cookbook, definitely make a little thing that helps people out with that. There's a lot of availability in that space. Blood pressure activity log, maybe, or blood pressure diary. Yeah, not too much going on there. Let's go with maybe like an IBS activity log. And we're gonna look at blood pressure. Blood pressure tracker and tracking. See what comes up. So, you know, I saw blood pressure on there. I was like, well, let me go down blood sugar and the blood pressure route and just start seeing what I find. That's what this keyword analysis is all about. And then finding those ones like, you know, that's a nice market right there. And then building off that mindful eating journal, right? And how other, what other words can kind of tie to that and find our niches that end up getting people to buy some books from us. So I appreciate you watching this discovery session and, wish you luck in your own.